drum, knock those drums, play drum, play drum, knock on drum, play drum, jump this drum, play drum, knock on drum, play drum, knock on drum, play drum, jump this drum, play drum, knock on drum, play drum, knock on drum, play drum, jump this drum.
Bring everybody a drink on me.
You sure know how to keep things live.
That's my business, keeping things live. And before I get through, I'm going to have everybody in town over here.
You sure will. You even got the preacher coming here now.
That preacher coming over here is my business. You keep your nose out of it.
I didn't mean nothing.
All right.
Ready? Granny!
Who is that? Someone's called.
Granny!
Keep on beating them drums.
Granny! Granny!
Ebenezer, what you mean by coming here disturbing the ancient worship of the jungle god?
I had to come, Granny. I just had to come.
Some evil spirit's troubling you. Who is it? Speak.
Tom Camp.
A devilish imp of the devil. Why should he trouble you?
It's the trouble I scared is going to cause Myrtle that made me come to you, Granny.
Myrtle? Is she home?
Yes, tonight. Tom Cat seen her get off the train, and he told John she was just the kind of gal he wanted for his jook. And he don't let him have her. Please don't.
That gal ain't for you, Ebenezer. I done told you. That gal ain't for you.
She's a good gal, Granny, and a lover. Why ain't she for me?
I can't tell you, but she ain't for you.
I don't know why you say that. I'll kill him.
No, you won't. The voodoo. I promise you that.
Thank you, Granny.
Now go on. Don't say nothing to her. Don't say nothing to nobody. Leave everything to me. To me. And the voodoo.
All right, Granny, but save her from him, please. Save her from him, because if you don't, and Tom gets her, I'll die.
Die you won't. He shall die the death of the quicksand, with his eyes blinded, trying to see the death that he can only feel, with the sucking sands choking the life out of his worthless body. Tomcat, spawn of the devil, this day you shall come under the spell of the jungle gods. Jungle gods, I makes a spell to cast this imp back to hell. In a pit of bile and sand, let him join his hellish band. Let no mercy stay thy heart. Jungle gods, make him depart. Crunch him. Crush him. Like a crumb. For you, voodoo, I beat the drum. Beat them drums. The ancient god Voodoo commands you. Beat.
Can't get no more.
Well, you better get some more.
I tell you, I can't get no more. I better not be seen around here. Here comes somebody coming now. Maybe some of my congregation.
Your way.
I won't.
Hi, Amos.
Good day, Brother Tom.
I hear you's plotting with the voodoo woman.
You're wrong, Brother Tom. You're wrong.
I knows I ain't. Never mind. I wants $20 before sundown. You go and get to me.
But I told you last night I'd give you all I could.
I know you did. But you such a big liar, I can't believe a word you say.
But I have no more.
Well, you better get some more.
Far from.
I don't give a daffodiddle where you get it from. But if I was you, I'd beg it from them church people. And if you don't, I'm coming over to that revival meeting tonight. And when I get through saying my speech, you ain't going to have no more church than a possum.
Brother Tom, can't you see that I'm not the same man I was when you first met me over 30 years ago? I'm a good Christian now. Please let me be.
Why should I let you be? I hate you, Amos. And I hate what you claim you is. You wasn't no better than me 30 years ago. And you ain't a bit better now.
I don't think I'm no better than you. I just don't approve of your way of living.
And I don't approve of yours either, so he's even.
But my way is the way to heaven.
Nah, ain't no heaven for our folks.
Shame on you. You should pray to the Lord.
How come you narrow-minded church people think everybody should think like you all do?
When I ask you to pray, I'm doing what the good Lord said to do. Go into the highways and the byways and preach the gospel to every living soul.
I didn't hear him say it. And you're wasting time telling me all that stuff. In the first place, I ain't paying no attention to you. In the second place, I don't know what you're talking about in the first place. All I know is you're going to bring me $20 across that bridge before sundown.
You talk as if your very soul depended on $20.
You'll find that your well-being does if you don't deliver like I ask you.
And $20 is a lot of money to raise in these hard times.
No, I don't believe in hard times. And another thing, you can try to get Aunt Hager to hoodoo me till you're blue in the face. Or you can pray till you get cramps in your knees. And it don't scare me. Because I ain't scared of Aunt Hager, her voodoo, you nor your God either.
Someday the Lord is going to strike you dead for your blasphemy.
I ain't even scared of that.
Lord, have mercy on this wicked sinner.
When is you and the rest of them praying fools going to quit praying for something you never get?
Through prayer comes peace.
Well, if that's all you want, you're welcome to it. But as for me, I want more. And I'm going to get it by hook or crook, and I don't give a hooray who gets it from.
Uncle.
Yes, daughter.
Supper's ready.
All right, honey. Just keep it warm.
That's a strange gal around here, ain't she?
Yeah, that's my niece, Myrtle. She just come back home from school last night.
Yeah, I seen her get off the train. Why don't you tell her who I is?
Why, Brother Tom, I'm surprised.
Why is you so surprised?
Why, she's a good gal.
Is that so? I'm a good man, too. Look at that.
She's a clean gal.
You don't say. And I just got to meet her. That settles that.
You's wasting time. Surely. You wouldn't want to take a nice gal like she is across that bridge to your jook.
That's just what I'm going to do.
Don't you mean that
you... would make better business.
Oh, Lord, how can a man live and be so wicked?
I don't know how wicked I really am, Amos. I'm so wicked, I ain't even scared of what's going to happen to me after I'm dead.
Nothing forward across that bridge to your place. And I dare not let them see me, Gwine.
I don't care if they see you or not. You better be there.
But it'll cause trouble in my church.
That's your business. When anybody starts trouble in my place, I knocks them down and drags them out.
He that lives by violence will die by violence, saith the Lord.
I don't believe nothing I don't hear with my own ears. Say, Amos, I was just thinking. I'll do a little favor for you if you'll do one for me.
Anything I can.
I'll forget everything I knows about you if you let me have that gal.
Well, I couldn't. I wouldn't.
Never mind the rigmarole. Is it a bargain or ain't it? Of
course it ain't.
Amos, you ain't just now know me. You know good and well that anything I wants, I get, don't you?
Yes, but you can't.
Don't tell me what I can't do. I done made up my mind I'm going to have that gal. It's just a matter of how long, that's all.
Brother Tom, you can do anything to me you want to. Go to the members of my church and tell them all you know. And if they drive me out after all these years, I'll go. But you better not touch my niece.
Don't be a fool, Amos. You's flying high as eagle with these church people now. And can't nobody clip your wings but me. Why, between us, we got the town in a jug. You got the Christian, and I got the sinners. And you can rob them washfoot buzzards all you want to, and I won't tell a one of them what I knows about you. And you know that's plenty. Now, can I have that gal?
No.
All right. You're ordering a coffin for your own funeral.
How you feel today?
Well, I ain't so good and I ain't so bad.
How's you all?
That's fine.
Well, I'm fair to middling, I reckon.
Well, you get home all right?
Yeah, on the 10:15 last night.
Where is she now?
Oh, she and Ebenezer washing the supper dishes.
That voodoo woman done start her gwines on again.
Uh-oh.
And most all the older members of the church is right over there every time they hear them drunk.
I don't care no more about Tomcat than y'all does. I'd like to see him out of town for more than one reason. But we mustn't bother Aunt Hagar.
Oh, she's bothering us, ain't she?
Brother Denson, the religion that we promulgate will stand up for itself.
Amen.
With the good Christians, yeah.
Sure.
But them weak needlings, they'll worship anything. Even that voodoo mess.
Well, Aunt Hagar's voodoo ain't altogether good. But it ain't altogether bad, neither.
Well, I can't see why it ain't altogether bad. Always jumping around and moaning half the night.
That voodoo mess makes me sick.
Don't you go to Aunt Hagar sometimes?
Go away from here, man. Is you a new fool?
Well, ain't you superstitious?
Does I look that way?
Don't you believe in superstition?
Is you going to ask me that again?
Well, sir, most everybody is.
I know it is, but I ain't. Of course, when there's itching on the bottom of my right foot, I know that's why I walk on strange ground. And when there's bells ringing in my ears that nobody else don't hear but me, I know them as death bells, but you can't call that superstition. Brother Dunson, there's only one thing that I'm showing up scared of, and that's a black cat crossing my path.
Everybody is.
Even white folks.
Well, superstition or no superstition, them drums keep me awake nights.
Do they?
And left me since the night. Steady you, Elderberry. I go tell the white folks, that's what I
me
do.
Me too, me too.
The white folks know it already, Dunson. But they don't pay no attention to our folks.
Not unless somebody's got to stop it. That settles it.
So far as I'm concerned, she can go right on with her meetings. Does a whole lot of good for some of us that ain't like no better.
Judging from the numbers that's going to a meeting, most of us ain't like no better.
But Dunson, you know what I believe? I believe that she is the only one around here that can drive Tomcat out of this community.
You reckon she can do that, sure enough?
I'm almost certain she can.
If she does, I'll forgive her for everything.
Honest, honey, I don't mind washing dishes with you.
You wouldn't say so if you did. Oh, good day, Brother Dunson.
Glad to see both of you,
Brother Dunson.
My, you look as fit as a fiddle, Whitney. I hope that school didn't turn you hay.
Wasn't that kind of school?
I'm glad it wasn't. We need a nice, smart gal like you is here all the time. Keep them other young gals' minds on something besides picnics and shindy.
And I know you know what to do it.
Well, I'll do my best.
I know she will. She looks just like her mammy, don't she, Amos?
And she's good like a mammy, too, mm-hmm. Doesn't she?
How can she help from being good when a good, clean Christian man like you raised her from a baby?
Well, I did my best.
And everybody in the community knows you did.
And we all love you for it, too.
Maybe I'll have a chance for long to find out just how much they love me.
And I've been with you, Amos, ever since the first Sunday we started the church.
And we'll be with him, too, till one of the other of us cross the River of Jordan on our way home to glory.
You're good, true Christians, both of you. I love your foot.
Now, it's just like I said when I come here. Yes. We got to get Tomcat out of this neighborhood, that's all.
Certainly, sir.
My boy means everything to me, and I ain't going to have him lost. Now,
I guess I'll be fine.
The white preacher of the church I've been cleaning up has been teaching me the Bible. And I've been trying to show Elderberry what I knows, and he say I know more about the Bible than he does.
Oh,
I ain't saying he ain't a good preacher, because he is.
What does your grandmother think about?
Oh, she don't know yet, but she don't mind.
Well, she's She tells everyone that you're going to carry her work on when she dies.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, why don't you?
Oh, nothing, except it might have been all right in the days of the jungle before we know it any better, but it don't amount to much here.
Well, I think she does very good work.
Well, if some of the things she does ain't good, she means them for good anyhow. She knows more about roots and herbs than anybody, I reckon. She's the only one around here can cure a snake bite.
No, but that...
I intends to do some of the things she taught me all right, but not all. You see, I intends to have the respect of the house in the daytime and not sneak around at night like they do down to Granny's. Mm-hmm. And then, too, I believe in the Lord.
But don't she believe in the Lord, too?
Oh, she prays, but she says she don't like to bother the Lord about things she can do herself.
And she don't believe the Lord will answer her prayers.
Oh, she believes that all right. But she say the Lord's so slow, she's got to beat the drums to help him long. Say, honey, you ain't forgot what you promised me, is you?
Forgot? No.
Well, I'm sure glad you ain't, because I's counting the days till we can get mad, and I'll be so glad, won't you?
You bet I will. Mm.
Ebenezer. Ain't I done told you that gal ain't for you?
Granny, why you keep telling me that? I loves Myrtle and Myrtle loves me, don't you, honey?
Yes.
Maybe you do. But she ain't for you.
Why, Granny, why?
Does you want to know why, Myrtle?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, I hates to tell you, but it's time you know the fate that awaits you.
Granny, I wants Myrtle and Myrtle wants me and I'm going to have her, too.
Wait, Ebenezer, till you hears what I got to say. I'm gonna tell you something that's gonna change your outlook on life. But it's time that you knowed it, now that you wants to be Ebenezer's wife. You remember your uncle telling you that it was me that tended your mammy when you was born?
Oh, yes, ma'am.
Well, it's gonna hurt you, but I mean you well. Your mammy wouldn't died when you was born. Only she was afflicted with a spell.
Granny, you mean...
You got to believe me, cause it's true. The spell that was on your mammy is now on you.
Oh, Aunt Hagar.
All your life, remember that I said you take your life in your hand the day that you wed.
You mean that just because my mother died when I was born, that if I should marry and have a child, I'd die the same way?
That's what I said, and I means it too. Cause if you has a child, what happened to your mammy is gonna happen to you. I'm sorry, honey, to see you cry. But I'd rather see you that way than to see you die.
Granny, I loved you with all my heart and soul. You're my only flesh in this world, and I suppose I ought to believe everything you say. But when you say, just because her mammy died the way she did, that she's got to die the same way, I just saw.
Oh, but Ebenezer, suppose she's right.
Oh, suppose she ain't. We shouldn't let that come between us. She used to scare me too one day. But now, most everything she say goes in one ear and out the other.
Ebenezer.
But I believe in Aunt Hagar.
Myrtle, there's some laws most folks won't obey, for which their children has to pay. No matter how hard your struggles, you can't overcome.
I know. You're just like all gals in their own hometown. I bet if you was down in New Orleans and I asked you to go out with me, you'd step on it.
I would not.
Oh, yes, you would. You can't kid me, baby. I know you, gal.
I think you're pretty fresh.
I'll go and fix that imp of the devil.
Will you please go away and leave me alone?
Not till you promise you'll come over and see me.
Well, I won't promise.
Nothing I can do to coax
you? Nothing. Now, please go.
Sure, I'll go, baby. With you.
Oh, I won't listen to you.
Just a minute.
Oh, let me go.
Now, don't get rough with me, baby.
You better let me go, I tell you.
Maybe you want me to take a little kiss.
Oh, no, you won't.
You think
no,
I
you
can?
Won't. Let me go, I tell you.
You think I can?
No, you won't.
I'll show you how I treat girls
alone.
When it gets rough.
Well, you dirty little...
Turn him loose. Don't stain your hands with his worthless blood. I'll fix him. I'll fix him. You're creeping, crawling, hissing, lizard-eating, poisonous black cat. Trying to ruin a good gal like Myrtle. Your soul is as black as the soot on a skillet. You stinking skunk. They ought to lynch you. But you ain't worth it. And if the sun goes down in this community on your worthless carcass, I'm gonna blind you. I'm gonna blind you, you hear me? Ebenezer.
Yes, sir.
Go tell them boys I said, beat them drums.
Yes, sir, Sammy, yes, sir.
Listen to me, Hager. The rest of you licks till it buzzes. I ain't scared of your voodoo. I'm in this town, and I'm in it to stay in spite of all of you. You hear me, Hager?
Ah, but there's a cloud of righteousness rising up again you. And the rain from that cloud wanna drown out.
I pay no attention to you, Hager. Amos, I'll be over to that church tonight like I said. And I'm coming with a muzzle loader. Loaded for bear.
Lord, save me.
Don't worry. He's closer to the jungle gods than he is to any other. Beat them drums. Beat them
half as loud when the wind changes.
You oughtn't be heard at all. This is the Sabbath.
Yeah, but Aunt Hager's doing something that we can't do.
I wish she'd stop them drums. I don't care what she's doing. Why? Stop them and get under my skin. Instead of praying, I want to get naked and go jumping around like some wild man.
Yeah, I know. It makes me feel that way sometimes, too.
Well, that ain't the right way for nobody to feel. I don't want to feel that way. She stops and soon after supper time. What in the world can she be doing?
She's doing what you wanted her to do, Dunson. Drumming Tom Cat out of this community.
Well, if them drums don't drive him, he can't be driving.
He's blind.
I wish he'd hurry and get. But if he don't, I'll be so crazy I'll be blind with him.
Them drums is my business, Dunson. The Lord don't know you, Dunson.
Is you coming to this church showing up, Hager?
You got eyes, you can see. Who is it coming in here to tame me?
Well, it's the Lord's house. Everybody is welcome.
Maybe the Lord's house all right, but it won't be the devil to pay in here tonight.
That's all.
What you mean, Hager?
You know who and what I mean.
Do you think that Tomcat is coming here showing up?
If he don't, I'll be terrible disappointed, and I never is.
Lord save
me. That's what I'm here for.
Stop them drums, Hager, please.
What for, Dunson?
Your church is over. Please, Hager, please.
I love them. I won't, Dunson.
Stop them. Stop my jacket. They make me feel like I don't know what.
They make you feel like what you is, not like what you think you is.
You stop that kind of talk to me. I don't take no part in your voodoo. I believe in the Lord.
Yeah, just as much as you can. But you got your first God. That's the reason you trembles like a leaf every time you hear them drums.
I won't listen to you.
won't. Come back here, Johnson.
Oh, let him go.
I won't.
Let him go.
Yeah,
bro. Don't make him act like that. He come back when he gets cool off.
But Hagar, I need him here back tonight.
He'll be back. Amos, I want to ask you something. What is that tomcat going to tell on you?
Oh, I'm ashamed to tell you, Hagar.
Unless I'm terrible mistaken, it ain't nothing to be ashamed of. What is it?
Well, it's something that I don't want to tell nobody.
Amos, ain't you knowed me long enough to know you can't hide nothing from me?
Sure.
Then why try?
Well, I feel like the Lord's going to straighten out everything for long.
All right, then I'll tell you something. For this time another day, Wild Thomas Cat will be tame as a tabby. Maybe you tell me this. Oh, yeah. You tell me this.
Walk over to that revival meeting. Gal problem solved.
Sure I will, Mr. Tom. You can bet on that.
I'll be back in a little while.
I wish somebody would start a song so we wouldn't get in the damn destroyed. Yeah, somebody would start a song. Good news! Hey, I'm good news!
Good news!
Beloved sister and brethren, as Deacon Dunson just told you, this is the first of our yearly meetings for the revival of our Christian spirit.
Amen.
Now, I don't
feel so good tonight. Uh-oh. So I ain't going to take no text. I'm just going to wander around on various and sundry subjects. But before I go any further, there's something I want to say that I know y'all already know. And that is that my heart is full of thanksgiving tonight to the good Lord for his goodness in keeping Myrtle, my niece, safe during her absence from my fireside. And for returning her safely home again. Surely the blessings of the Lord is mighty. And we should be thankful at all times for his extreme goodness and mercy.
We sure do, we sure do.
As I said before, I ain't going to take no chance. So the first thing that I'm going to discuss is the word revival.
That's a good word, Elder.
Now I'm going to explain the full meaning of the word to you. Not that I don't think you already know, but just for my own personal satisfaction. Doing it easy. Because from all the signs I know anything about, we're in for electric storm. And I know y'all want to get home before the roads get wet.
We sure do, we sure do.
Oh, I ain't seen nobody go, man. If it gets wet.
Me? Now, there's something I've been aiming to tell you for a long time, Brother Zero.
Amen.
Double long.
Tell it to me, I'll tell it to him.
You knows, and everybody else in here knows, that things ain't always what they appear to be. Sometimes you think that your dog sees a possum, then you look up and behold, it's a skunk. Then another, you think it's a skunk, and you find out it's a possum. So it's always best to investigate, for by your lack of foresight, you misses a good meal.
Now you're talking, Elder. Keep right on.
What I'm trying to get at is that no matter what you hear or who you hear say, if it's about me, look into it before you do the same. For 30 years, I have ministered to this flock.
Oh, you have.
Not only did I baptize the most of you, some of you are also Christians.
Don't you know I know?
So you know, or at least you should know by this time, that at all times, you can depend on me.
I know you can depend on me.
When your heart is filled with trouble, when your phone's picking your bed, when you feel like a lost lamb, wilderness of darkness, send you for me. When your head is hung low, with the standing in the world, something is in front of you. So tall you can't climb over, and you're so low you can't creep under. Send for me. I'll be there just when I lift the heaven low. You know what I'm going to do. I'm asking you, do you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to talk to you about the dog. The only lovely dog. The only one that knows when the squirrel died. And the only one that knows whether the squirrel to hair down the nose or whether the squirrel to have something.
I ain't so sure about that.
Now that you understand how I feel, I'll proceed with my discourse on revival.
Go on. I'm listening.
In order to get the full benefit of these meetings, you must first get the full meaning of the word revival. Therefore, I'm going to explain it to you as I said before. Now, I've been looking this word up, and according to the dictionary and the encyclopedias,
what are you talking about?
Revival means to revive.
I know this, but I tell you all what it was.
Not only to revive the spirit of our religion, but to revive our most innermost desires to do good. Now, understanding fully what's meant by the word revival, we all should strive to be faithful.
Oh, Lord, revive us!
Revive us! Lord, revive us!
Look into our hearts. We need revival!
Yes, Father, do it!
Some of our faith have revived and sold off. D.D.
Now, bless them with the Spirit.
All the New Testament brothers need reviving. Yes. Why am I here spreading gossip? Why am I here spreading scandal?
Yes, sir.
Why am I here spreading malicious rumors?
Yes. Talk about
it! I'm telling you and you and you and you, you can't do me no harm.
Yes.
For my very heart, my very life, it's subjugated to the Lord.
Yes.
And you, Brother Vero and Brother August, they know y'all's business why I go when I leave this church. Don't I preach the word of the Lord to you?
You do that.
Don't I pray to the same good Lord for you?
You do that.
And then what more does it take to satisfy you? Did you like the scribes and the Pharisees of holy writ? That is always questioning the ways of the holy.
There is that.
I'm asking you, angel.
Yeah, if you talk about me, I want to tell you, you is a long ways from being a holy man.
But Vero, you good Christian, Vero. You let it
stand on
you,
Vero.
Brother Bill,
I say you's out of order. So
sit
down and shut your mouth.
All of you
sit down.
Stand out of the master street.
I'm still the pastor of this church.
Well, excuse me, Elder.
Well, what did you want to say, Brother August?
Well, if you just give me a chance to explain it, I think I can tell you what Brother Zero's trying to get at.
I wish you would.
Well, he told me that he saw you come from Tomcat's jook. And he's wondering, like we all is, what business could you, the shepherd of our flock, have with Tomcats and his rather dubious undertaking?
That's it.
But did it ever occur to either one of you, brother, that I might have been over there on my own personal business?
Of course he was.
And it ain't none of your business.
Now, Elder, please don't misconstrue our intention. You see, it's like this. Tomcats ain't no decent place for decent folks to be wise.
It sure is.
And naturally, I'll leave it to anybody. We don't want you, our pastor, to be blind there.
We sure don't.
Brother August, I goes where I wants to go, when I wants to go, and it ain't none of y'all's business why.
Well, I hope that letter found you home.
Now, Elder, you must remember, you was a man of God and a minister of the gospel. And it behooves you, first of all, to be careful. Very, very careful.
And it feels to you like...
It don't only feel him. You was it.
Where do you think you see me?
I ain't thinking nothing about it. I knows I've seen you hold nice hand running coming from across that bridge that leads the Tomcat's race of gambling men and scarlet women.
I won't sit here and hear you insinuate just down the barrel like that. You, Brother Jerome, knows as well as I does. If he went across that bridge, he had a good reason to.
Yes.
And it wasn't to gamble with them gambling men.
Yes.
Or to sashay with them scarlet women.
I ain't saying he was, but he was over there. And if he wasn't over there for one of them things, what was he over there for?
I don't know. But I know Elder Barry.
Yes.
And I know that he's a good, clean Christian man.
Yes.
I know he's been that way for 30 years.
Yes.
And I knows that you can't teach an old dog new tricks.
Elder Barry ain't no dog, sister. Now,
you know what I mean.
You heard what I said.
Don't you come out it with me.
He's in the
place. Yeah. We ain't in no place for all this wrangling.
God, you serve people all your lifetime. And then they try to crucify him.
Don't you worry yourself about them backsliding hypocrites, Amos. Don't you do it.
I ain't no hypocrite, sister, tonight.
And I ain't no backslider. And to prove you that I ain't, if Elder Barry don't give a foot-pound reason why I went across that bridge, I'm going to leave this church.
That's why, right, get out. Don't you think this church is where I stop because you quit? You ain't no good here, no harm.
Brother August and Brother Zero, you ought to be ashamed of yourself. The way you carried on in this house of righteous worship tonight.
You keep out of this. Don't take none of your business.
It's just as much my business as 'tis yours. This is a revival meeting. This ain't no meeting to try out a barrier.
It sure ain't.
I leave it to the members of the congregation. Did we come here to listen to all this wicked arguing?
No.
Or did we come here to listen to the words of the Lord?
We want
to
hear it all.
Of course you does, and I does too. And it aches my very heart to see you all wasting your time when you ought to be serving the Lord.
Tell them, Bawdy, there was neither you and Bawd with them.
Well, thank you, Brother Ebenezer. Now, sisters and brothers, I know the way to end this for all time. The good book says that an open confession is good for the soul. So I confess it. Brother Zero was right.
Just a minute.
Before you condemn me, remember what the Savior said. Judge ye not.
That's just what I was going
one here's to be teaching the gospel of the Lord. Amos the soul saver. Y'all, he's a saint. But if you only know what he really is.
How many times?
I can stand right here and tell you plenty.
You'd better stay where you is.
Think I'm scared to come in?
The Lord would strike you dead there into his sacred temple.
Pray for Amos. I'm man enough to look out for myself.
Tell us what he come over there for.
Yeah.
All right, I'll tell you. Amos Berry ain't the man your kid.
Well, what is he? What is he?
He comes over to my place to pay
That's
me.
Enough.
I'll tell him. Sisters and brothers, I go over to his place and pay him money. Not to tell y'all that I was on the chain gang once.
What were you on the chain gang for?
Murder.
Now you see what kind of man he is?
A man, a liar, a cheat, a hypocrite, leading us to glory. Come on with that boy now.
Stop right where you are, every one of you. You all know Elder Berry, and you know if he killed anybody, he had a good reason to. Why don't you wait and find out that reason? Is you going to let a man you all know is a thief, a gambler, and an infidel turn you against a man of God like Elder Berry? No. I said no. Run this infidel devil out of the house of the Lord. Come on, you God-fearing Christians. I'll lead the way.
Turn back. Once one of you buzzards lays a hand on me, that's the one. I told you that anything I want, I'll get. That gas. I'm going to have her. Nothing ain't going to stop me.
Give me that. Stop. I'm blind.
Lord, honey, I was looking everywhere for you.
I was standing at the library. I was wandering around. Aunt Hager found me and brought me here.
Oh, I'm so glad she did.
Where's Ebenezer?
Why, he went to take Tomcat home.
What's the matter with him?
Why, he's blind.
Delightful.
Aunt Hager said she'd blind him.
And he's blind, too.
And just to think, Ebenezer took him home, even though he tried to cut him.
Why, no one else would touch him.
I don't blame him. He's just as pious as a cottonmouth box.
But he can't do no harm now, Hager.
Yeah, but a blind snake will strike quicker than one that can see. You knows that.
Yeah, it holds no malice.
No, you wouldn't, but I does.
Thou shalt not do it.
He said that. He didn't know Tomcat.
But after all, he's human.
Not as human as the alligator or Gila monster. Because even they don't tackle the females when they ain't willing.
Do you think you'll get over that blindness?
Not if I can help it.
Well, at that, I wish Ebenezer would hurry and come on.
Oh, Uncle, let me go to the bridge and meet him.
Oh, no, honey, you'll be all right.
Oh, please let me go.
Let the girl go.
Thank you, Aunt Hager.
Now, hurry back, honey.
Yes, I'll be all right.
All right.
Amos, did Tomcat tell your congregation anything what's going to harm you?
He tried to, Hager. But I stopped him and told him myself.
What'd you tell him?
You remember when I left here a long time ago, running on the boat from New Orleans to Memphis?
Yeah, you was gone from here 5 years.
Yeah. Well, 4 years of that time, I was on the chain gang. And Tomcat knowed it. That's what he's been holding over my head all these years. He's been just bleeding me for every cent that he could. And I paid him because I didn't want him to tell my congregation about it.
What was you on the chain gang for?
Well, I killed a man.
Your congregation would have hadn't been for Sister Nick.
Yes, Lord bless her. And I pray to the Lord that it's all over.
Hmm. Well, you can pray if you want to, but it ain't all over. And it won't be till we get out of here. Where is it? Where's the door? Where's the door? Where is it?